on to me, Crafty Wonder here, and today I'll be doing a review on my neon art book. I have personally already used this book before. It is an awesome book. I actually got it from the bookstore. I don't know where you usually bought it, but I have made some creations, like this owl, and then inside let me open the book first. Inside, I made a fish and a gecko, which was a complete fail. I also made a fail right here when I tried to make an owl. And also, I failed. I failed on doing the frog, because the paint went all over. And then when I folded it up, you see how when I folded it up, it turned into my own personalized fish, which looked so awesome. So basically, that's the tail, and those are the two fins, and then this blue part right there is the mouse. So. Okay, let's make it on my table. And if you guys can see, I have laid out some newspaper because there's acrylic paint that comes with it, and it will get a little messy. So I just put newspaper on this for nails. So yeah. So what this kit comes with is 2 tubes of neon paint, 4 neon colored pencils, and over 70 neon stickers. So this is what it looks like. So there is green, is that pink or red? Orange. So wait, that's orange, yellow, green, pink, orange. Yellow, orange. That makes more sense. Okay, let's see what I should make. The only one that I didn't make was the firefly, the tree frog, and the parrot. I really, 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 really want to make the... Wait, no, I don't know why this looks so... I really want to make the parrot. So we're going to make the parrot. It's going to be awesome. We're going to make the parrot, okay? So what you have to do first is you have to rip out one of these pieces of black paper. And it says at the back also what it includes. Kit includes drawing book with instructions, 16 tear-off sheets of black paper, 4 neon colored pencils, and 2 tubes of acrylic paint, and 72 neon stickers. But it's just 70. Over 70 neon stickers. Not, which also means 72 because it's over 70. I need to get something, guys. I need to tell you. So you know how my friend, she gave me Equestria Girls Applejack for my birthday. She also got me this cute bear and 5 other movies. Ooh, which were The Naughty List, Abominable Christmas, The Santa Buddies, Polar Express, and the last one was Arthur Christmas. Yeah. But she actually gave me 6, but one of them were Peppa Pig, but I didn't want that because I do not watch Peppa Pig, so that's why I gave it back to her. Okay. So let's begin. So first, what we have to do, as I said, we have to rip out. Oops. That was my second attempt. I don't know if I can show this. So that was. I don't know. It's too dark. Yeah, you can see me. I'm gonna turn on the light a little. Okay, there you go. Where is it? The second. Sorry, guys, it's just taking forever to show you this. Okay, this is my second attempt to be making the owl, which does not look very good to me. So Sorry, guys, I decided to talk to my mom right now. So that's my brother. Okay. Open this up and get my black sheet of paper. Okay, so this is what you're gonna do. So there's a little dotted line. So you fold on that line, and then you just gently rip it off. There you go. That wasn't gently, I saw that. So here we have the piece of paper, and then I have the instructions with me, and I don't have to show you it. I don't want to show it to you guys so I can concentrate. So I'm just going to show you the two pages, and then here the other page. Okay, let's make it. Okay, let's do this. What color does it show? Show that your drawing is the yellow. Okay, get the yellow out. Okay, open it with the paint. Okay, first it says draw a curved line for the head and chest, which I don't know if I could do that. I'm gonna have to do it this way because I'm on the right side of the camera. The page. Can I rip out the pages? Oh no, for not this. Okay, so draw. Yeah, a draw. Okay, and then it said add a shape like an upside down teardrop for a wing. I am not good at making teardrops. Am I showing you this? Okay. I am not good at making teardrops, so here is my failed teardrop. Ah! Oh, I made like a lily. Okay, wait, I need to redo that. Sorry, guys. Okay, so draw a curve. Okay, this is a teardrop. Pointy, and then you curve, and then it's a point. There you go. That's better. Well, they did a little bit longer here, but it doesn't matter. Okay, and then it says, add a round shape for the top of the leg and a long tail feather under the wing. So, and I think I need to make this a little bit. Okay, so it's going to do that. And then it's gonna do, sorry, I'm just sniffling right now. I'm just sick right now. Under the wing. Okay. Draw a curved line at the side of the eye area. Add a round wing. Draw a curved line. And then add a round. This looks horrible right now. But I'm just trying my best. Add a round eye with a small black pupil. But I don't even have a round black. It's making no sense. Okay, then it says, add a hooked upper lower beaks and a... This is making no sense right now because, I don't even have black, which makes no sense. Because they didn't add black and they're adding black right now. Oh my god, this is so hard. And then add it right there. Sorry. Like that. Oh, it's actually wavy. Oops. And then another wave. And then it says, draw a branch for your pair to stand on. Oh, you have to do lines for us, the feathery effect. So leave a comment down below if you like it so far. I personally do not like my old picture because I'm not that good of a drawer. When it comes to animals, no. But when it comes to humans, yes. And now I have to draw a branch. How am I going to do? I'm under where the tail is and just skip the tail, don't go through the tail, and then you just make a little thingy point. And then you're just gonna make some leaves. I'm gonna do only three leaves, but it shows that they did like five. Yeah, five. I'm gonna do three instead. Okay, I'm done! So, this is my finished picture, and now I'm going to color it with the same color as it is here. There's not that much green and blue to it, so what I'm just going to do, yeah. For this part, I'm not going to use the green paint, because the leaf is the only part that's green, and plus, when I squirt it out, it's gonna splat everywhere. Okay, let's begin coloring. So this part, I don't even have white in here. Like, this is making complete no. It's just making no sense. Okay. So let's start with the pink. With this pink, yeah, that's pink. I'm just gonna color the top part of the wing pink, and then you're gonna color the. Am I showing this to you? And you're gonna color this part, the top of that pink, but not the eye. It's gonna leave the eye white because there's no. I mean the eye blank because there's no white. Okay, then I colored the thing yellow, like there. Okay, and then you need to color this pink as well. And this pink as well, and then the right side of the wing, the tail thing, and then that's all pink. That's a lot of pink actually. Okay, then I'm gonna use my orange. Orange. Yeah. This looks like pink, but it's not. Though when you look at it first. When you look at the tip, it looks like pink, but when you draw it, see the difference? You see the difference? Yeah. Then you do these. Orange just sticks. Orange. Okay. And then, what else is orange? Okay, that's all that's orange. Okay, now for yellow, this part's yellow, and that's pretty much it. And then for green, I'm gonna get green. That's gonna color the leaf instead of using the paint. Okay, now for the pink part. It's gonna put a dollop, and then since there's a little part, you can just spread it out with the paintbrush. Okay, and then see how neon that is? You can see it better. So I'm just gonna use that for the beak too, cause I want it to be shown, and also for the feet. And then for this part, do a little. Okay, so I have completed my thingy. No, I want to do my eye green, so there's more color into it. I'm gonna add more color. I'm gonna add more colors to it, so it looks more nice. Boop. I have a question, guys. Does parents have green eyes? I'm just curious. Curious. Okay. So now with the paint, I'm just gonna do little lines everywhere. It's kind of cool. That's what I did with the owl because it looked kind of plain. So yeah, I did lines. So I'm just gonna I'm running out of blue, so I'm just gonna use green for the rest of this thing. Oh no, I'm running out of green too. I need to get paint. Oh my god. Oh. My masterpiece! My masterpiece! Okay, it doesn't matter. Well, that actually looks pretty nice. I'm gonna do dollops. Oh, that's too much. I'm gonna put in this the sun. Okay, wait. I'll be right back because I really need a tissue. So sorry about that, guys. And look! I also decorated my orange pencil. So this is what it looks like. It looks kind of neat, actually. I'm gonna add some more color to the branch. So just put dots everywhere so that it can relate to the splash that I did. I'm gonna do another big thingy. Okay, I can't do that there, but okay, you know what? I'm gonna do splat. Okay, so here is my finished drawing, but there's still a lot of space left, so I can decorate with my stickers. Okay, so my first one, I'm gonna put, since it's a bird, there's only an owl sticker there, so I'm gonna get that owl sticker. My only owl sticker, because there was only two owl stickers, and I used one of them for my owl painting. Wait, no? I used it for my gecko. Aww. Shouldn't I use it for my owl? Okay, then I'm gonna add a butterfly. Ooh, butterflies. Be careful not to rip the sticker. It looks pretty, so it's on right beside the branch. Okay, then next I'm gonna add a ladybug! And it's gonna be flying in the air. And then I'm gonna put maybe a tree. Yeah, tree down. To represent that parrot being on the branch. Going with the bug theme, if you guys can see, I'm gonna put a dragonfly or whatever that is. Maybe under, right there. And then, oh, why didn't I just use this big sun sticker? So dummy. I didn't know that. Okay, I'm gonna put a star sticker. This is not going with the parrot theme. I'm just putting stars to look that cooler. Oh, maybe some flowers. Yeah. Maybe I'm going to put the flowers on the leaves because it's representing that it's spring and there's all these flowers and awesome blossoms and they're all... Okay, I need one more. Is there one more? Oh, there's only two. Wait, no. Oh, yeah. Okay, then I'm gonna use this one. It's a different type of a flower, but oh well. Okay, so no, I got on my pants. This is why you need okay, legit. Know what? Okay, I'm done. I'm done. There was another dragonfly sticker. Okay, you know what? I'm gonna put on one more heart. I mean, one more sticker, which is gonna be a heart. Okay. So, guys, this is what it looks like. Wow! I just put on the heart that was on the back of the book. See? The same exact heart. But this, the pink looks a little bit darker. Okay. Wow, we also put the same dragonfly, same ladybug, and the same two flowers. Didn't you see that? Oh, didn't you see that? Okay. So, here is my... I know, for some reason, you know the eye is green, right? And that part's right beside it. How would you know which one's the eye? It looks... Whoa, isn't that cool? It looks like a face right there. We take out the beak, one, the two eyes, and then that squiggly face. Doesn't it? Other than that, if you add everything, it looks like a parrot. Not that much. I'm not a big fan of the how I made the beak, but the rest I really like. Wow, the feet, when I draw the feet with the paint, when I put it upside down, it looks like a heart. Isn't that cool? Okay, so I hope you enjoyed this video, guys. Thank you guys for watching it. Peace out, homie. Bye, guys. And don't forget to subscribe, like, comment, share. And don't forget to watch my other videos. So, and stay tuned. So, peace. Bye, guys.